Okay, pilots. I'm going to put me a new ESC in my Dynam Tempest. Now, this is pretty simple here on this one. I've already opened up my cockpit here. Disconnected my throttle. Reach your hand right in here and you grab a hold of the wire, you pull your ESC and all your wires right up through the front. Now again, I'm going to be using an E-flat 40 amp ESC. They seem to be working pretty well. I've noticed on just about every one of my Dynam planes that they've got the red lead going into the black lead, and the black lead going into the red lead on the ESC. So I'm gonna hook it up the same way manufacturer has it. And I said before how these bullet connectors are fitting pretty tight. They seem to do all right. I just don't know. I don't think it's the ESC. I believe it's this little fuse looking thing that they put at the end of the lead that goes into the ESC. I don't know. I throw that thing away. Well, usually I just throw the ESC away too. But I'm going to need my little fishing tool here. Fishing tool. And the JU-52 bomber conversion. The next step was to find a high-speed medium bomber.
Do that hole
that
there.
On another plane originally designed as an airliner, much like the JU-52.
Let's see here.
In the early 1930s, Ernst Haeckel decided to build the world's fastest passenger plane. A lofty goal met with more than a little skepticism by the German aircraft industry and its newly evolving political leadership.
This way.
To everyone's surprise, they delivered
this way.
Delivering an aircraft superior to the already fast Lockheed 9 Orion, the AG-111 Docket Prince, or Double Lightning. The design immediately garnered the interest of the Luftwaffe brass, which was looking for any design that could be pressed into military service. The AG-111B1 was completed as a bomber prototype and kept secret. First flew in February 1935, and was followed quickly by the civilian B-2. The B-2 had a smaller wing and used the bomb bay as a four-seat smoking compartment, with another 6 feet behind the rear fuselage. The B-2 entered service with Lufthansa in 1936, along with five newly built versions known as the AG-111.
Let's pull that battery plug to them.
Uh-oh,
I forgot something. Maybe that's why I didn't want to pull that battery plug through. I'm going to cut my cover off. I like to cut that cover off. Put me a new blade on the end there.
Became the first aircraft of the newly formed Luftwaffe to enter war action. While the aircraft
straight pot. I don't know what it is.
German military assistance expanded rapidly in the succeeding months. At the beginning of November, it was officially amalgamated into the Condor region. This consisted of 100 airplanes and 5,000 men under the command of Hugo Spröth. By rotation of the contingents, a total of approximately 20,000 Germans served in Spain and received valuable combat experience. Adolf Hitler justified this involvement as part of a fight against Bolshevism. The Spanish Civil War also provided the Germans with the opportunity to test new weapons and tactics. The Messerschmitt BF-109 fighter, Heinkel HE-111 medium bomber, and later the Junker JU-87 Stuka dive bomber, first saw active service in the Condor region. These aircraft played a major role during the early years of the Second
World War.
Luftwaffe markings were replaced so as not to make the world believe that Germany was actively supporting the revolt. Instead of the Nazi Party's swastika on the tail, the German planes used the Nationalist Air Force aircraft markings. The Condor revolution also included non-aircraft. There were Panzer tanks with Panzerkampfwagen 1 white tank, commanded by Wilhelm Ritter von Fulmer, destined to be second in the heavy effort. And sailors who trained from other naval stations. The Germans also tested their 88mm heavy anti-aircraft artillery, which they used to destroy Republican tanks or the engines in the
town. Okay, now let's get our throttle hooked up.
On November 4th, 1936, Russian fighters near Madrid shot down the first Ju-52. A further six aircraft were shot down during the next few weeks. It became obvious that the
Ju-52 throttle hooked up, 206 channel gyro, that comes out gyro, and I do believe I've already got it programmed in my radio here. I'm going to hope this thing's going in the right direction.
Was a dive bomber to support ground operations. This was fulfilled by the Junkers Ju-87 heavy dive bomber, popularly known as the Stuka.
Stuka.
After Hitler came to power in 1933, Wolf began to convert the theoretical concept of the dive bomber into a real force in Germany. Ernst Fudet, the head of the aircraft development program of the Reichsluftwaffe, was very impressed with the demonstrations of a Curtiss aircraft he saw in the USA in 1933. After he had flown the Curtiss Hawk, he bought two, which he demonstrated in Germany. These American aircraft helped to advance the case of the dive bomber in Germany. The emphasis on
let's hope she sings her little song here.
For dive bombers rather than level bombers.
Falls down.
It was felt that the former were likely to be much more accurate against pinpoint targets, such as troops' concentrations. This was true, and the Stuka would soon be feared throughout Europe. But it diverted resources from the development of the so-called Ural bomb, which planned for strategic attacks on long range energy targets. This created
a that's the tight fit. See, I can put a that's a 2500 there for sale. I can put a 4,000 in there for sale, and it fits just as tight. I mean, even just a little bit, maybe even a little bit tighter. And don't have to put no Velcro, don't have to put no strap or nothing on. But a 4,000 gave my Hurricane the perfect CG with the 4,000 pushed all the way forward. Like I said, this is a 2,500, yep, 2,500. Because I've got my 4,000 still in my Hurricane, wanting the weather to break here, so I can do a taxi test on it. I got three of them I got taxi tests. Three of them.
Uh-oh.
Well, it's not bound. Something's wrong. Maybe when you take MESCs off, maybe there's some kind of a something going on there. Go with it that way.
In Spain, the Stuka legend would begin, and the Luftwaffe would finally get a chance to show its
glory. Got my red light blinking slow.
On 27 April 1937, gave the Luftwaffe an opportunity to test its bombing tactics.
Turn it on. Gear was reversed again. Okay, at least it was clear. Okay. So what was that? Like they got a delay to them or something. Alright, my prop going the right direction. Oh yeah. That could be just the bearing in the motor. It could be, I don't know. But it is going in the right direction. I might take that prop off and see if them mount screws is tight. Oh, I wanted to check. Let's see here. Should be this one. Yep, that's it. Turning my gyro on. I didn't do this on my Hurricane. Check to see if my directions are going in the right. Corrections are going in the right direction. Well, that one is. That one is. My rudder is not. My rudder is not going in the correct direction. And let's see here. Actually, no, they don't. Well, that switch was in the wrong position. Okay. I'm going here. There's a gyro in here somewhere. Yeah, here we go. Okay, y'all, we need to switch y'all. Okay, I've got the yaw fixed. That's right. Okay, now that's gyro on. This is just stability here. So it should cause the aileron to go up, but then just go right back down. Yep, that's what it's doing. Okay. We got that set up for it.
I'm a husband and a father of two. I slipped.
So now I'm gonna go here to.
But I beat my addiction with the help of American.
Gains, and I'm gonna put that on 30. It has it on 50, but I'm gonna put it on 30. Go to roll gain. Bring it down to 30. Okay, now I've got the gyro on, and a while ago that aileron was moving almost an inch. Now it's barely moving a quarter of an inch, okay? That's what you want. You just want that thing to move just enough to get that plane level back up. We're looking pretty good, Terrapice. We're looking pretty good. I'm gonna turn that gyro back off. Set up. FMS 182 trainer LED set pilots. You can get it at any FMS dealer. ESCs I got on eBay. It was like a couple dollars cheaper than you could get them at Horizon Hobby. That's my Dynam. Tempest, Hawker Tempest. I'm out.